I have traveled many moonless nights, cold and weary, with a babe inside, and I wonder what I've done. Holy Father, you have come and chosen me now to carry your son. I am waiting in a silent prayer. I am frightened by the load I bear. In a world as cold as stone, must I walk this path alone? Be with me now, be with me now. Breath of heaven, hold me together, be forever near me. Breath of heaven, breath of heaven, lighten my darkness, pour over me your holiness, for you are holy. Breath of heaven, do you wonder as you watch my face if a wiser one should have had my place? But I offer all I am for the mercy of your plan. Help me be strong, help me be, help me. Breath of heaven, hold me together, be forever near me. Breath of heaven, breath of heaven, light in my darkness, pour over me your holiness, for you are holy. Breath of heaven, hold me together, be forever near me. Breath of heaven, breath of heaven, lighten my darkness, pour over me your holiness, for you are holy. Breath of heaven, breath of heaven, breath of heaven.
Good evening and welcome to Christmas Eve at Central Baptist Church. I can't tell you how happy I am that each of you is here. We gather for worship this evening to remember that God loved us enough to become like us, that God loved us enough to come and be with us. There is no more complete revelation of what God is like, of who God is, of what God wants for us, or of what God wants for our world, than the baby in Bethlehem's manger. The Christ child is God incarnate, full of grace and truth. Would you join me now in prayer? God of Christmas, the one we've been waiting for, We celebrate your arrival and offer ourselves to you this evening as completely as you've offered yourself to us. With words of adoration and joy, with songs of reverence and praise, with hearts that are both stilled and stirred by the overwhelming power of your presence and the overwhelming testimony of your love, we gather around the manger to worship you and to celebrate all that your presence means for our world. In the name of Christ who comes to be with us, we pray. Amen.
This is a night of for which we have prepared during these 4 weeks of Advent. It is the night for our Lord's birth.
We light the candle of hope, reminding us that Christ is the hope of the world.
We relight the candle of peace, recalling that John the Baptist and the prophets foretold the coming of Christ, the Prince of Peace.
We relight the candle of joy, reminding us of the joy of the shepherds when they heard the good news.
And we relight the candle of love, reminding us of the extravagance of God's love and that we are called to love extravagantly too.
Now we light the center candle in our Advent wreath, the Christ candle. Through Christ, God's light came into a world lost in darkness. His truth, his love, and his very self transform all who receive him. God sends God's Son tonight so that through him the world might be saved. Let us pray.
Loving God, Emmanuel, we thank you for sending your Son to light our world. Grant that the hope, peace, joy, and love of which we have spoken may be fully realized in us as we worship and serve you through Christ Jesus. May the light of Christ shine on us and through us tonight and every night. Amen.
Come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. And it came to pass in those days that was sent out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
And so it was that, while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were sore afraid.
And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all that they heard, it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. I'd like to invite all the children to join me down front. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Not quite yet, though, right?
Tomorrow.
Can you believe that it is Christmas Eve today? I cannot. I bet your parents can't believe that either.
You are my parent.
I am your parent. You're right. How many of you plan to wake up early tomorrow? Raise your hand.
Yeah.
I know it's going to be exciting to open your presents, and I bet many of you will get to eat a special breakfast. That's one of my favorite things. I know at my house, my girls plan to wake up early, and so we have a rule that if you wake up before mom and dad, you cannot go downstairs until mom and dad are awake. Do y'all have any rules like that at your house?
Yeah.
So because of that rule, mom and dad try to be fair, and we set our alarm, and we try to wake up before we think they're going to wake up. And we do a couple of things, like get our coffee. In the last couple of years, since we got our dog, I usually have to take her outside before things get started. And taking Lucy, our dog, outside and turning on the Christmas lights has become one of my very favorite moments of the year. And do you want to tell me, you want me to tell you why? Now, all the other days, it's not my favorite. But on Christmas morning, it's my favorite. Because when I walk outside my house at 6 o'clock in the morning, on Christmas morning, it is absolutely silent outside. Most mornings when I get up at 5:30 or 6, it's quiet out there. But on Christmas morning, it's silent. It's a silent night, just like that very first silent night when Jesus was born. There are no cars on the road. That train that goes by my house every day is not going by my house that morning. Nobody's outside. Do you know why? Because everybody is at home. Because the whole world is celebrating that day, the day of Jesus's birth. Very few stores, or no stores are open, hopefully. Very few people are working. Very few people are out and about, especially that early in the morning. They're all at home just getting ready to celebrate the birth of Jesus. And even though our presents are going to be exciting to open, we have to remember the reason why we're opening them. Do you remember why? Because we're celebrating the fact that Jesus was the best present we ever received. So we're going to have that good food. We're going to have those good presents. We're going to have fun time with family. But we have to remember the best present we ever received all day long tomorrow. So whether you have a silent moment like I plan to have in the morning, or just sometime during the day you set aside to just have a moment to remember what it is that we're really celebrating tomorrow morning, can you do that?
Yes.
And have fun, too, while you're at
yeah.
it. All right, let's
yeah.
pray.
Good food.
Lord, we are here so excited about what tomorrow will bring. Help us remember while we're opening our presents tomorrow that the reason we give and receive presents on Christmas is to remember the most precious gift ever given, your son, Jesus. We give you praise and thanksgiving for all you have given us. Merry Christmas, Lord. Amen.
Falling, hearts are breaking, how we need to hear from God. You've been promised, we've been waiting. Welcome, Holy Child. Welcome, Holy Child. Hope that you don't mind our manger. How I wish we would have known. but long awaited. Holy stranger, make yourself at home. Please make yourself at home. Bring your peace into our violence. Bid our hungry souls be filled. Word now breaking heaven's silence. Welcome to our world. Welcome to our world. Fragile fingers sent to heal us, tender brow prepared for thorn, tiny heart whose blood will save us, unto us is born. Unto us is born. So wrap our injured flesh around you, breathe our air and walk our sod. Rob our sin and make us holy, perfect Son of God. Perfect Son of God, welcome to our
This is my favorite night of the year. And this is my favorite service of the year. And in a few minutes, we'll take the flame from the Christ candle and spread it all over the room and lift our candles high as we sing, "Sleep in Heavenly Peace, Sleep in Heavenly Peace." And you'll get to share in my favorite moment of the year. Christmas Eve has always been my favorite evening. There is a safety and a warmth to tonight that no other evening provides. Whatever it is that's going on in your life, turmoil or challenge or whatever it is, we all have something. They don't touch us. In this moment. Not tonight. God's presence at Christmas is greater than them all. Sometimes I wonder if God would really come to be with us. If the all-powerful, almighty God, ruler of heaven and earth, if that great big God would really come to be with us in the form of a limited, earthbound, hidebound human being, and as a baby, no less. Sometimes I wonder how that could possibly be true, but not tonight. Not on Christmas Eve. God's presence is greater tonight. So tonight I do not wonder. Instead, tonight I marvel at the awe-inspiring truth that we are all here to celebrate. Fred Craddock used to talk about the power of lingering, of slowing down and loitering even, as opposed to rushing and hurrying. He said that lingering was the luxury of people who always knew where they were headed. He said if you always knew where you were headed, then you could afford to linger and loiter and marvel. In England, several centuries ago, it was in great fashion for people to spend Sunday afternoons together walking in the countryside. They would gather together and go out into the fields unhurried and without distraction, unworried by the cares of tomorrow, unworried by the shortcomings of yesterday. And Craddock says they called that practice marveling. Going marveling. After church, they would look at one another and say, "We're going marveling this afternoon. Wouldn't you like to go with us?" Christmas Eve has always been an evening of marveling for me in just that way. The pace this evening slows. Tonight you can afford to linger and loiter and marvel. Unhurried, unworried, and without distraction. A few Wednesday nights ago, our children performed a Christmas musical that told the story of how the Christmas carol Silent Night came to be written. In 1818, as they taught us all, Franz Gruber, the church organist at the Church of St. Nicholas in Oberndorf, Austria, found himself without an organ at Christmas. One of the pastors of the church, Pastor Moore, had written a poem that he thought might make a good carol for the congregation to sing on Christmas Eve. He asked Gruber if he could come up with a tune simple enough to play on the guitar. That way the congregation would have a song to sing on Christmas Eve, even without the organ. Well, on Christmas Eve, the little Oberndorf congregation heard Gruber and Moore sing their new composition to the accompaniment of Gruber's guitar. Weeks later, a well-known organ builder arrived to fix the organ in St. Nicholas Church, and when the repair was complete, the organ builder asked Franz Gruber to play something to test out the repaired organ. When Gruber sat down, his fingers automatically began playing the simple melody he had written for Pastor Moore's Christmas poem. Deeply impressed, this organ builder took copies of the music and the words to Silent Night back to his own little Alpine village. There, two well-known families of singers heard the song. Captivated by Silent Night, both of those groups began to sing the song every Christmas as they traveled. Silent Night, Holy Night, all is calm, all is bright. In 1834, Silent Night was performed for King Frederick William IV of Prussia. When he heard the song for the first time, he ordered that his cathedral choir sing it every Christmas Eve thereafter, and they did. 20 years after the song was written, the song was first performed in the United States, in German at first, at the Alexander Hamilton Monument located outside of New York City's Trinity Church. A church and monument made famous today by those making the pilgrimage to see Alexander Hamilton's grave in the wake of the hit musical, Hamilton. By 1863, Silent Night had been translated into English. Today, the words of Silent Night are sung in more than 300 different languages to Franz Gruber's simple tune. And those words will be sung in every one of those languages tonight. So we sing them together right here, tucked away in a quiet corner on Christmas Eve, just off the square in Noonan, Georgia. As we sing that song and remember with others all over the world that God's promises to us are true. Tonight is my favorite night of the year. And now we do approach my favorite moment. A moment to linger. Unhurried, unworried, and without distraction. A moment to go marveling. Won't you go with me?
Silent night, holy night.
Bow with me for our benediction. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory, full of grace and truth. Amen. You may extinguish your candles. Merry Christmas.